BCN Retail is a Japanese market research firm that collects sales data from various retail outlets in Japan and provides insights into the camera market. So they've released their information for 2024, and Olympus Pen EP7 has ranked 7th on their list of best-selling mirrorless cameras, and it has a market share of 3.9%. And in the BCN Awards for mirrorless cameras, Olympus has been knocked out of the third place. So if you look at the previous year, OM Digital Solution was third place, and it's been like that for previous years, for quite a few years. And if you go further back, it would have been in the second and first place for quite some time. But this year, it's been knocked out of the top three places. So Nikon has taken its place. So you have Sony, Canon, and Nikon in the top three positions, and OM Digital Solutions has been relegated. However, in the audio recorder category, OM Digital Solutions came up first with 41.7% of the market share. And then you have Sony in the second place. There's a good review of the OM System 12mm f2 lens. So if this lens is something you're interested in, I think it's worth looking at this review. It goes into a lot of detail about all the different aspects of the lens, such as chromatic aberration, distortion, and it has side-by-side images for comparing those things. So if this is a lens you're interested in, I think it's worth looking through this review for all the details that it has. And there's a lot of sample images as well. Canon has developed a sensor with 410 megapixels. So effectively, this sensor can create a video footage with 24K, which is 198 times greater than full HD and 12 times greater than 8K. But for the sensor to be able to output 24K, it can only do so at 8 frames per second. But they do have a feature for 4-pixel binning. And what that does is reduces their resolution to 100 megapixels, and then they can output video at 24 frames per second. So because I use cameras mainly for recording sports and live streaming, the megapixel count doesn't matter that much to me. But what is important is how long the lag is on the sensor, so whether it has rolling shutter effect or not. So having a global shutter to me is more important than having a 100 megapixel or 400 megapixel camera. But obviously this depends on the type of photography or videography that you're doing, so everyone will have a different need. But for my purposes, lower megapixels but less rolling shutter is definitely always preferred. There's a DIY kit for creating a camera. So this is a film camera, obviously. You can take these pieces apart and put them together to create a camera. And the idea behind this is that you learn about cameras and how they're constructed by putting one together yourself. And it's called Konstruktor, in case anyone is interested in putting together your own camera.